What's up, my ninjas? Today I'm going to show you how to make those reactive images at the bottom of your screen when you play with your friends, the ones that like pop up in color when they're chatting with you and then they go back to a gray color when they're not. So this is what you need to do. In order for this to work, you guys have to be in a Discord channel together chatting. And the first thing you're going to want to do is check your settings and go to developer mode. Developer mode is under appearance. Scroll down right here. So this is it. Make sure it's on in order for this to work. Cool. And the next thing you want to do is pick that voice channel that all you and your friends are going to be in. So I have one and I name it Stream Live. So now that you have that channel set up, you're going to open this site called Discord Stream Kit Overlay. I'll link it below. You're going to install for OBS. You're going to want to go to voice widget, hit that server that you're using, hit the voice channel that you're using, Stream Live for me, and then grab this browser source right here. So with this browser source, you're going to have to use this source for every single person that you want to make an overlay for. So for example, say I want to make an overlay for my friend. I'm going to go into Streamlabs OBS. I'm going to add the browser source. I'm going to name it friend one. How's that? Usually you'd name your friend here, whatever. You're going to paste this browser source right here. This is the same browser source you're going to use for every single person that you're trying to add to your stream. So it doesn't change. It's one thing. Now that you have the browser source URL, you change the width and the height. You're going to want to change the custom CSS to this code. I'll link this code below for you guys to copy and paste. But it basically just kind of tells you what you need. So it says not speaking URL. So this is where you put the image of your friend not speaking. So to get that link, find the images of your friends. I like to put it in a mod room so that it's always there and it doesn't move, because once that link is disconnected, your browser source will no longer work. For example, I'm gonna go to my mod room. I see my friends. I'll use myself for this example. You're gonna get the ones that's not speaking, copy that link, and you're gonna put that between the brackets right here. You say it says not speaking. You're just gonna paste it right there. You grab the one of it speaking, copy link, paste it between the speaking one, right here, speaking URL, paste that. You also want to paste ID here. So this is the Discord user ID of your friend who is speaking. So I'm going to grab myself and put it right here, like so. So I'm going to copy this whole thing. I'm going to go to my browser source CSS and paste it and hit done. So now that's me. And you can see it's talking when I'm talking. Yeah. And usually I would just make it smaller and grab it, put it here. You can make it bigger, however you like it. It's your friend, now I have doubles of me, who's quiet when I'm not talking, and like that. So this is what you're gonna see when you're streaming. You're gonna have to add this for every single person who is gonna join your game that day. And they shouldn't appear if they're not in the Discord server. So for example, if I were to leave, look, my little icon friend is gone. But as soon as I join back, she appears. If for whatever reason, your friend is appearing when they're not in your channel, that means your browser source is incorrect and you need to go double check that you have everything set up properly. Because just know that that browser source URL is only linked to this voice channel, my Stream Live, only this one. So that's all you need to do. You shouldn't run into any problems as long as you copy the whole link below, or if you copy the browser source properly. You want to make sure that you have one specific voice channel for all your streams. Otherwise, your friends aren't going to show up, and you want to make sure you have all of them set up. Of course, it's going to get a little busy in your browser source as you start having more friends join you, because every single friend needs their own browser source. Make sure you remember that. If you don't want to manually enter all that information every single time, Jin Channel actually made a website. It looks like this. Jin VTuber made this website. He's actually the first person who I saw this tutorial from, and he explains everything here in words, but he also, on the very end, shows you a custom CSS generator. So if you don't want to go through that manual labor, go ahead and just click this link also below, enter all the stuff here, same idea, and it'll just generate that link for you to paste in your browser source. Once again, make sure you have all the browser source accurately pasted. And that's all this tutorial is about. I had a lot of people asking me about it, so hopefully this helped. Once again, Jin's the one that first discovered this for everyone, I believe. At least for me, he did. So shout out to him. Use his CSS generator link. Just support him. He's great. And that should be all. Feel free to message below if you have any questions, if you have any suggestions for tutorials I should do. Go ahead, like, subscribe Jin's channel as well, and I'll see you guys in the next tutorial. Later.